We begin this journey in Lyon, France, France's second largest city, situated on the confluence of the Saône and Rhone rivers. In Besançon, we board the barge, Janine, and will travel on the Doubs River, the Rhone and the Rhine canals, the Saône River. The Burgundy Canal connects the Saône to waterways leading to the Atlantic Ocean. Construction began on this canal in 1775 and was completed in 1832, connecting the Mediterranean to the Atlantic.
And you're going to see that we also have renovation from the 19th century, but this is the beginning of the old town, St. George.
After visiting the Basilica, we see a couple of the amazing buildings painted to fool the eye. Local artists have been painting these for the past 40 years. Parts of Lyon's old city have hidden passageways which helped the residents during the occupation, and we walk through some of these passageways. Finally, we visit a local silk weaver whose family has been trained in this craft for many generations.
Quality that you can have, and then they have it colored in resin, and then they put it on the spins themselves.
Je vais vous faire
30 years ago.
Et elle est un peu spéciale parce qu'elle est posée dans le château le plus connu en France, à Versailles, en tapisserie.
Because this is a sample of the tapestry of Versailles. So when they renovated the castle about 30 years ago, his father had to leave everything to cover the walls of the castle. This is their special piece.
Pour refaire tous les tissus à Versailles, ça a pris 20 ans.
It took about 20 years to weave all the material that they needed in Versailles.
Regardez, c'est une collection qui date du printemps 1902.
And this is a collection that was made in the spring of 1902.
Exactement.
So those were the colors that were released for the spring of 1902. Of course, they can still use them, but that was the style in 1902.
Where does the dyeing get done?
La teinture aujourd'hui c'est au Brésil, ils ont tout le matériel pour le faire.
When the silk arrives here, it's been dyed already in Brazil because they have all the material, all the workshops, all the factories to do it.
Mais avant quand il y avait beaucoup d'ateliers, les magnaneries, donc la soie était cultivée dans le sud de la France, des régions comme l'Ardèche ou les Cévennes, et on faisait la teinture dans la Loire à 1h30 de Lyon parce qu'il y a une très bonne qualité d'eau.
In the 19th century, of course, we had so many silk weavers, we had so many workshops that we had to grow our own silk and we had to do everything. So they would grow the silk or they would grow the cocoons in the south of France, then they would put the threads together and they would dye it about an hour and a half away from Lyon in the Loire, so not the Loire Valley, but along the Loire River, because we have a very good water quality. And the quality of the water is crucial for a good dyeing.
Now it's time to introduce you to MS Janine. On the main deck is a lounge with outdoor area, the bar, and the dining room. Cabins for the guests are on the lower level, eye level with the water below your window. Here is the staff on ship, and Zoltan, our hotel manager. and we will travel from Besançon to Dijon. Perhaps this will show you how it feels to go by barge. Each of the 54 locks required a flurry of activity by the crew. Each lock has a number. Many of the lock houses have a sign telling you how far you are from a previous town and how many kilometers to the next one. Between locks, passengers can get off and either bike or walk along the towpath.
We're doing 54 lots. That's what he said.
And what number is this?
I don't know. We must have missed a few.
When going through a lock, the water level probably will vary by about 12 feet, either up or down. There are excursions available off the barge. This is the Royal Salt Works south of Besançon, a former salt production plant. Today the site has UNESCO designation because of its architecture rather than for the industrial activity for which it was built. Salt was a very important commodity in 1775 when the construction began on orders of Louis XV.
That's the guard house, which was at the entrance, accommodating the guards, obviously. Half a dozen guards that were living in here. Not only the guards were living in the guards' house, it was also the accommodation for the caretaker of the place and the priest of the soldiers. And at the entrance, you may have noticed something a bit unsettling. There is a false grotto at the entrance, which is kind of unusual for a factory entrance. That bears a lot of symbolic meanings. It could be a reminder of the natural cave from which the rock salt was coming and which was at the origin of the production in here. Can also be a more philosophical reminder of the myth of the cave of Plato. But there are many, many other interpretations around that false grotto. So bear in mind that it's bearing a lot of symbolical meaning. You may have noticed that on your way in, there's a large, 3 meters high wall that is going all around the complex, closing entirely the complex. So because of that, the people were living here in a closed circuit. And with that idea in mind, the architect designed a place in between the wall and the buildings. That place was for kitchen gardens. So the workers here had a little place where they could grow a bit of food. It was also a way to keep them within the complex and to keep watching them again. And again, surveillance is highly important here.
This site was chosen because of its proximity to forest, the thought being that it would be easier to pipe salty water here than to transport wood 20 kilometers to the salt site. The architect thought by having workers live in a community on site, they would be more efficient and avoid distractions elsewhere. Thus, the buildings were constructed in this walled area where surveillance of the workers could be accomplished. Salt was manufactured here until 1895. The site fell to ruin until 1927, when it was purchased by the local department and restored more or less as a museum of salt production. Here's a bit of country scenery as we drive back to the barge. This hospital was established in 1443. The finest materials were used to ensure its continued existence for centuries. It was classified as a historic monument in 1862. Charity and care have been their mission even today at the new hospital. This is the region's traditional barging hub at the confluence of the Saône River and the Burgundy Canal. We are in the heart of Burgundy's Grand Cru wine region. Every vineyard is unique depending on the soil and the variety of grapes grown. Another side tour from the barge to visit this old winery and then have a tasting. Thank you. We've arrived in Dijon, the capital city of the historical Burgundy region. It's known for mustard, vineyard tours, an autumn gastronomic fair, and wonderful architecture.
When you open a jar or a pot of mustard, you have to close it and to have it in a fridge, because otherwise it will be good, but you will lose this hot effect, you see? And people did eat a lot of mustard because of religion, or thanks to religion, it depends the way you think. And it's because you remember that during Middle Ages in France, Catholic Church was telling to everyone what he will do in the next 5 minutes, you know? It was very, you had to do according to what they said. And all along the year, they had a lot of days with fasting. In fact, you say meatless meals. It's a very good expression, because it doesn't mean that they didn't eat. They were eating, but no meat, fish, egg, vegetables, several things, but no meat. So, to pep up the flavor of the dishes, they used mustard.
The well-preserved town center has cobbled streets, timber-framed medieval houses, and the owl is a symbol of Dijon.
Region where we are, so it's coming from Burgundy. Okay, of course we can see the color of the cheese, and we know something about this cheese. But we know
Wash cheese.
Exactly, but it's a special cheese.
We thank Zoltan for his informative cheese tasting.
Avec entre autres avocat, copeaux de parmesan et filet de magret fumé. Ce sera suivi par un filet de saumon avec une sauce vin blanc citron, un petit légume et des aubergines grillées. Et comme dessert, ce sera une panna cotta aux fruits jaunes. Je vous souhaite un bon appétit.
And we thank the chef for all the delicious meals.